Hello and welcome. My name is Murray Voss. I'm the technical manager here at Safer Group. And today I'm going to be going over the entire Raptor range. In particular, today will be the davits, and then we'll be going over the needle systems, and then we'll be going over the Raptor rail systems as well. Okay, so here we have the first of our standard davit range. This is the smaller of the three models. We have three different main models, mainly being the height and the outreach. So this is the 1600 model, which is 1600 to the underneath here by 1 meter out, and then we have the 1400 arm as well. So that's the 1400 reach. The next model is then 2200 to the underside, and then we have a 2600 model as well. The cantilever on all the sections are also interchangeable in that we can have a 1 meter or 1400 on all of those three systems as well. The davit is mainly made up of aluminium components, a very high strength alloy, which is anodized to give it its longevity out there in the weather. And then the structural components like this one down here is made of a stainless steel. So powder coated stainless steel, and we have stainless steel attachment points. Other thing to point up is the simplicity of this davit system. It comprises of three main components. So you've got your post, you've got your cantilever arm here, and then you've got your brace. So with those three components, and very simply easily adjusted or removed with the five pins, it makes the system very easy to mount and dismount, and also when moving around from base to base. The davit arms are rated to a 12 kilonewton load, which is the rope access requirements for Australian standards. We also have the same model with additional strengthening, which can be rated at 15 kilonewtons if required. So there we have it. That's the first of our standard base range. If you're looking for more details, such as loadings and reaction loads in the base, please refer to our main manual, which has all these details. All right, so this is our next model. Very similar to the first model in that it's got all the same components, but now this is the 2200 high. So from the base to the underside, 2200 high, and then you can also have the 1 meter or the 1400 module available. Still has the three components and the stainless steel components. So although this davit is very large, it can still be easily manhandled by one person for each of the components, making it very easy to assemble and disassemble. Finally, we have, this is our big beast. So this is the one that goes up to 2.6 high. We have a 2.5 standard model and then a 2.6 model if requested. So still has the three components as per the other models. This particular model has an additional internal sleeve, giving us that additional strength for the extended height. This particular model is also rated at a full 15 kilonewtons, even with the 1400 extension arm. This one is a little different. This particular one you'll notice has the brace now in the front. What this allows for is if you've got an area here with a wall or something where the rear brace does not allow for that clearance. So we've got this one with a brace in the front. What you do need to remember though is that you do require this particular area, so you can't have a parapet or any structure in this area because it is needed for the brace. So this particular model shown is the 1 meter. We can do up to a 1400 extension. However, we are limited on the height here. The height limit here is 1600, and that's because anything bigger will require a bigger brace. But there we have the front cantilever type davit system. Okay, so onto our final davit at this stage. What we have here is one of our newest inventions. It's the davit system which we've mounted on rails. So we call this a rolling Raptor system, the rolling davit system. And you'll notice here we have the two Raptor rail systems, and in here we have trolleys. So what that allows you to do is actually roll up and down the entire facade and getting access over the other side of the facade. So obviously there's quite a bit of engineering required on this particular davit. We will need to make sure that it's coordinated with the construction and the erection of the building. A couple of things like the minimum requirement we allow to have these rails between is about 700 millimeters in between. So there are a few limitations because of the loads and so on, but this does allow for a very easy, flexible system for the operators, so they can virtually move up and down even whilst they're on the ropes on the outside, cleaning the windows or maintaining the systems. And this davit here comes out of this cradle. So we have a cradle for each section or area, and then this davit then gets removed from the cradle, also in the three components, and then can be moved from place to place using the cradle on the rail systems. So there you have it, that's our rolling davit system. All right, now we're gonna go over the different range of davit bases. Of course, it all depends on your application in the type of base that will be used on the project. What I want to point out here is these two here are the most common types of bases. So this particular base is also made that is 65 millimeters high. If you have a situation where you got to get the base underneath some pavers, so elevated pavers, then we use the 65 mil base option. It can also be used for a standard base option. So once mounted, you will see that we have this other tube assembly, which can then be dropped into place. And then it has these four pins, which get put through on each of the mountings with the safety pins all the way around. And then you put your davit into that. We call this our low profile type base. Now, moving on to the next one. So this particular base we refer to as the standard or the floor mount base. Obviously this makes the operation a lot easier because you don't have additional pins and so on, but sometimes because of the low profile requirements and so on, that is a better base. But moving on, this is our next most common base here. It has everything all in one, obviously very simple. Just mount with one of our mounting kits or the chem sets. The requirements and so on, and once mounted, the davit will just mount inside with the pin going through. Obviously on all our bases we have this particular attachment point here, which can be used for either tethering your davit system whilst you're assembling or for an anchorage point while working close to a full edge. And then the next one we're looking at here is our concrete mounted type davit base. So this needs to be cast into the concrete. Now I will just emphasize with all these bases, you must make sure you look at the specifications for the concrete, because in this particular case the concrete does need to be a lot thicker than those particular ones there. Another thing to remember is that because this will be inserted into the concrete, we do have this cap as an optional extra, which can be put over the top to stop any water ingress and in turn ingress into the concrete structure. Then we're going to our wall mount base. So the wall mount system, obviously this gets mounted onto the wall in this situation here, and then the davit will sit in this socket as shown. Now the mountings are shown in our technical manual, but they are basically an undercut type anchor which gets mounted to the wall. All right, and then we have the cast-in cage system. With the cast-in cage system, this is obviously the best method to work for any of the davit systems. Obviously, it has to be mounted and put in at the time of the concrete pour. What that does mean is that a cast-in system does not require any pull testing. So you'll notice the blue washers here. That is another indicator when you tighten this down onto the base, when you see the blue washer, you know for full well that this is a cast-in application and no pull testing is required. This system here, very easy to assemble, very important to keep your bolts located right to ensure that once the concrete is poured, the base will then just go on top of the bolts. So as you can see, these top four nuts and the washers is then what clamps your base down. So that's the concrete cast-in cage system. All right, so there you have it. Some of the most innovative range of rope access davit products. Very light, very easy to use, and most of all, making it safe for the operator. If you have any other requirements, please reach out to our technical team and we'd love to help you out. Thank you.